Hey everyone, ever heard of time series forecasting? Forecasting helps us make future predictions. Did you know that something as simple as the summer heat can send energy demand on the grid through the roof? Think about it. Millions of air conditioners cranking up at the same time. Today, I'm going to show you how to predict hourly energy demand using a cutting-edge AI model from IBM. We're diving into the world of multivariate time series forecasting, but don't worry, I'll break it down step by step. What's the magic behind our predictions? The IBM Granite Time Series models, also known as Tiny Time Mixers. These models are open source, lightweight, and built on a TS mixer architecture composed of multi-layer perceptron modules, making forecasting not just powerful, but super accessible. And we'll use these models through the watsonx.ai API, so you can follow along from anywhere. Now, these models aren't just one-trick ponies. They're foundation models trained on all sorts of public data sets, from energy demand to IoT sensors and even Bitcoin prices. Because of this, they can adapt on the fly and do zero-shot forecasting. That means they can predict new data straight out of the box. How powerful are they? They've been trained on a massive 700 million time points. Seriously, that's a lot of data, including the Monash Forecasting Repository and the WATSA collection. And with context lengths of 512, 1024, or even 1536 data points, these models can handle everything from short trends to big picture patterns. All right, let's roll up our sleeves and jump into the code. First things first, to use the watsonx.ai API, you'll need an API key and project ID. If you're not sure where to get those, check out the video linked below. We'll walk you through it step by step. Once you have your credentials, fire up Python 3.11 or later. We're using a Jupyter notebook here, and we'll be using a few essential libraries. OS and getpass for credentials, wget and pandas to load data, numpy and matplotlib for visualization, and the star of the show, IBM watsonx AI for connecting to the time series models. We'll also grab the mean absolute percentage error, MAPE metric, from sklearn to check our predictions. Let's bring in our data set. 4 years of hourly energy demand from Spain, already cleaned up and ready to go. Each row is an hour, with columns for different energy sources, weather data, and our target, total load actual, the actual energy used. Quick pro tip, always peek at the data before you start modeling. Now we need to split the data. The last 512 rows become our history for the model. The following 96 rows are set aside for testing how well our predictions match reality. We'll set the model to predict total load actual, using all the other columns as context. That way, it learns how weather, generation, and other factors play into demand. Here we'll plot energy usage over time, so you can spot trends and outliers. The watsonx.ai SDK lets us see all available Granite Time Series models and their capabilities. For this demo, I'll use the 512 context length model. It looks at 512 hours of history and predicts the next 96. Just set up the TS Model Inference class, plug in your model, set up your parameters, and you're ready to forecast. Now for the fun part, forecasting. With a single API call, the model crunches the numbers and spits out predictions for the next 96 hours. We'll visualize our predictions, the gold line, against both the historical data, the blue line, and the actual data, the green dotted line. Where gold overlaps green, our model nailed it. To put a number on accuracy, we use MAPE. For this demo, we scored under 10%, which is excellent for real-world energy forecasting. And that's it. With just a few lines of code, you can predict future energy demand, or honestly, any time series data you care about. Want to try it yourself? Check out the GitHub link in the description. Bring your own data and see what you can forecast. If you found this helpful, give it a like, subscribe for more AI tutorials, and let me know what you're predicting in the comments below. Happy forecasting.